my great pleasure to announce the President of the Republic of South Africa, Mr. Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela.
We are both humbled and elevated by the honor and privilege that you, the people of South Africa, have bestowed on us as the first president of a united, democratic, non-racial, and non-sexist South Africa to lead our country out of the valley of darkness.
South Africa is known as one of the most developed countries in sub-Saharan Africa,
but has one of the highest income inequality gaps in the world.
In the summer of 2009,
the Social Enterprise Institute at Northeastern University led an innovative and interdisciplinary program offering students the experience of engaging in fieldwork outside of the traditional classroom, emphasizing the ability to work in emerging market economies such as South Africa. South Africa was chosen as a site location for students because of its rich cultural diversity, its history of apartheid, and its stable business environment, which has the potential to bring people out of extreme poverty. Led by Professor Dennis Shaughnessy in the College of Business Administration, the field study program recruited 20 Northeastern students whose courses of study include everything from entrepreneurship to finance to international affairs. The field study program is unique and different from traditional study abroad opportunities for many reasons. Firstly, students are prepared in the classroom before they depart through the social entrepreneurship course offerings. Secondly, while on the ground, the program model is designed to allow the students to work within existing successful social enterprises.
The Institute also partners with academic institutions to incorporate local students,
allow for cross-cultural exchange, and bridge sustainability.
One of the most important distinctions is that the Institute offers students the ability to work in the field
in addition to studying in the classroom, allowing them to receive experience working directly with the poor and marginalized in the areas of research and business consultation, among others. In addition to working and intellectual capital, the Institute brings financial capital to invest in designated field projects in order to make a direct economic impact on the communities they work with. Typically, the program also incorporates a week of service activities to engage in service learning to close the experience.
South African students whom are admitted to TSIBA
come from township communities or urban slums where unemployment rates, though largely undocumented, reach upwards of 60%. These students receive the opportunity to attend college through significant scholarships provided by the university. Similar to Northeastern, TSIBA's approach to education is grounded in experiential learning and internships.
The students wasted no time getting to know the unadvertised side of Cape Town,
and were immersed in South Africa's rich history through powerful guest lectures such as Amba Kathrada, a political prisoner for 26 years on Robben Island alongside Nelson Mandela, and site visits to local townships, museums, and socially minded enterprises, or businesses that exist for purposes beyond that of turning a profit. Streetwires is a locally owned company that is a prime example of this type of enterprise. Streetwires provides skill training, financial support, and raw materials to disadvantaged South Africans whose lives have been affected by HIV or AIDS to create bead art that gives its employees a chance to have sustainable employment and income for the first time in their lives. The consultation teams help 10 small business owners or township entrepreneurs with varying skills and services such as website development, marketing plans, writing new business plans, and building financial models. The consulted entrepreneurs worked in various industries, including catering, manufacturing, and microfinance. Our student consultation teams were assisted by high-tech MBA alumni who provided business development expertise, leadership, and guidance. One of these entrepreneurs was Jose Joao, founder and owner of Comida Catering. At an early age, he was forced to flee his native country of Angola as a refugee during the Angolan Civil War, which ravaged his country for more than 3 decades and forced more than 50% of the population to be displaced. Jose found himself in South Africa, like many refugees, stateless and without work or an education. Throughout his first years in Cape Town, he worked in various banking positions and gained the skills necessary to open his own business when the opportunity arose in 2008. Northeastern students, Christine and Scott, worked with SIBA students to help Jose expand and build his business. Jose's team worked closely with him to assess the needs of the company and to improve them. The team helped build him a website, identify his strengths, conducted market research, and created an implementation strategy for Jose outlining some of the important steps to running a business. In order to efficiently bridge the sustainability plan, Northeastern and SIBA helped to create a micro-venture fund
with seed capital of over 60,000 US dollars, or almost half a million South African rands,
to help support and grow small businesses. The closing of the academic portion of the program consisted of the student teams making presentations to a select panel of SIBA and Northeastern faculty or staff members in order to determine which businesses would receive an investment or what the institute deems micro-equity capital to support the businesses. In addition to the financial support Northeastern provides to small businesses,
the Institute has also provided 3 interns, or co-ops,
through the Social Enterprise Institute's co-op initiative in conjunction with the Office of International Co-op. These student positions help to further sustain the micro-venture fund and also provide students with the opportunity to further develop their career aspirations in the field of social entrepreneurship.
Throughout the program, the students spent their weekends volunteering and completing service projects.
Northeastern students teamed up with SIBA for their 5-year anniversary to work with the Neil Mellon Township Trust to build houses for homeless South Africans that live in squatter communities or shacks. Students performed various tasks from laying bricks, mixing cement, or painting houses with the organization's mission of providing quality social housing for the impoverished communities in the townships of South Africa. On Mandela Day, one of South Africa's newest and proudest national holidays, Northeastern students, accompanied by their SIBA classmates, fed and participated in games and activities with over 300 children at the Priceless Honor Orphanage in the township of Gugulethu. The closing week of the program was spent in KwaZulu-Natal with God's Golden Acre Children's Home for Orphans. God's Golden Acre houses over 80 children who are terminally ill or have lost parents and relatives as a result of the AIDS pandemic. KwaZulu-Natal has one of the highest HIV infection rates in the world, with a prevalence rate of over 30%. Approximately 1 in 4 children in KwaZulu-Natal has lost a parent due to an AIDS-related death. Northeastern students fundraised over 13,000 US dollars through grassroots initiatives to help God's Golden Acre in their mission to help HIV-positive children and their family members. Students worked on several different service projects while in KwaZulu-Natal, including significant renovations and additions to the children's playground and the creation of 2 additional spaces for the children to complete their homework or a resource room.
Victoria Mpenge.